Mind if I join you in here? It's a bit wet out there.
Oh yeah, no, feel free now.
You guys just gonna sit out in the rain all night? All day? Are you sure John hasn't been drinking? He seems to have nodded off.
Huh? Hey, you never know with that boy there.
Hey, John.
If you guys don't mind, I'm just going to take a little nap for a minute or two.
Do you want to use the tent?
I'm feeling very tired. Nah, it's okay. I'll just go underneath a tree or a bus or something.
Well, it's really tipping it down now.
What do you mean they're tipping it?
I think it's raining really hard. John seems to have wandered off.
This is John!
I'll have a little wander along this creek, I think you'd call it. I'll be back here in 5 minutes, how's that sound? Unless you want to come with me?
Alright now. I'm going to be right here in this tent now, just in case Mrs. John comes back.
Hello, gentlemen. What's the problem? What's the problem?
Oh, that's where you are.
I haven't got a problem.
Oh, we were just trying to get out now with the way you down went, at all.
No. I was looking for an axe, you see. I need an axe.
I got one. Here you go.
To make the fire.
There you go. There you go. That's your feet there.
I'll leave you guys to. I'm just gonna have a wander for 5 minutes. I'll be back here in 5 or 10, yeah? Okay.
I got a radio but no battery now.
I'll be back here, but if you need any help or any trouble, just fire off a shot and I'll come running.
Yeah.
Alright now.
See you in a second.
What are you gonna win you?
I'm just gonna have a wander along this creek and see what I can find.
Oh, you good old scouting mission, yes?
Yeah, sort of. You're welcome to come with me.
You've after this area before. Nothing.
Okay, I'll see you shortly.
I don't want to cast too many suspicions, but if that man's sober, I'm a bloody vicar. I have a quick scout about looking for some vital medical supplies, but I don't want to take too long. It tells me that John may be a little bit more drunk than he likes to let on. So pretty soon I head back to the camp to meet up with the guys and see what's going on.
Hey guys! Guys!
Hello?
Hey dude.
Hello, sir.
So I was looking for some medical supplies.
It's William.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've lost Walter. I don't know where he is.
Has he wandered off?
We're off over the top of the hill.
Let's go and look for him.
Yes. It's a jolly good idea, sir.
Show me where you last saw him.
Yes. We were over the hill here.
This guy sounds absolutely wankered.
It's very kind of you, William. Very kind of you indeed. Show the way. You'll help me find Walter.
What was he looking for?
We're building a fire, you see.
Ah.
We found a fireplace.
Walter! You found the fireplace?
No. I found the house with the fireplace. And I said, you go over there, Walter. I'll be there in a moment. I've dropped some logs. And he just disappeared, you see.
Oh dear. I fear this might be my fault because I was hoping to find a place I can cook my beans up. Is it this house over here?
Oh, beans. Oh, I do love beans. I do love a pan of fried beans, you know. Not as good as tea. No. You haven't got any tea on you, have you?
No, you've already asked me.
I do love a cup of tea.
It's been years.
Walter, where are you, Walter? This is house down here, sir.
Let's go and have a look in there.
Let's run. Just run to the tree. Walter!
Looks deserted.
Walter! Are you in here? Bugger.
Just let me rest a while.
There's nobody in here.
Give me 2 seconds to catch my breath. I'm hot.
Yes, you do rather look sexy, not black and hot, you know. I'll give him my number for the time.
He knows this house, though, does he?
Oh, yes, he knows this house well, because he was we were here the last time before. To cure his sickness, you see. He couldn't wander off far. Surely not.
Let's go out into the town and have a look around. Walter! Walter!
Walter!
Where are you, fella? Walter!
Walter, where are you, goddammit man? Please, Walter!
Where are you at now?
Hey, Walter, where are you?
Oh!
I'm over by a big two-story brick building now.
We're trying to come to you.
Main road now.
Yeah. Oh, I can see it. There you are.
Okay, I see you now.
What are you? You're frightening me, sir. You're frightening the hell out of me.
You done went took off now. I turned around and you was gone after you done shot that tree down in 2 swings like Paul Bunyan.
I said, I'm going to the greenhouse where we had before. When you had the sickness. But no. You have to put your adventure first. Oh, sorry, William. He's such a card, you know. He always fucking kills wandering off. Like a little Forrest Gump, you know. I made a fire.
Okay, well, I'm going to wander I'm going to have a look around the town, and I'll come and meet you at the house with the fire, yeah? I'll be able to find it because of the smoke.
Oh, yes. You'll see the smoke coming out of the chimney. It's the brown house on the edge of town.
Okay, I'll see you there in a few minutes. Just gonna check out the whole town.
Okay, William. Thank you. Come along. Come along. Oh, what am I gonna do with you, young sir?
Oh, nothing. You're gonna be my friend, Mr. John. That's what you're gonna do now.
Hey guys, it's only me.
Oh, you okay? We just in here getting warm by the fire.
Yeah, I'm actually too warm, so I'm gonna stay outside probably. I'll just come in to check out your homestead.
Yeah, hey, Mrs. John, you fall asleep now.
Oh, that looks nice.
You done dropped it through the floor, didn't you?
Well, the liquor was so good. I must have dropped it through the window, you know.
So it seems young John has been drinking after all. Surprise, surprise.
Oh, you got some whiskey. I can see whiskey, but I can see whiskey. You know. Yes.
There you go now. There you go. We need some more logs now. We need to get some more logs.
I'm just going to pop down to the river again because I'm feeling rather hot. So I'll be back in 5.
Alright, man. We're going to be right here.
Okay. Don't wander off again.
With any luck, by the time I get back, John will have passed out. Hopefully he'll wake up and be more his normal self. But I don't like to take too long still. You never know. So, after a quick dip, I make my way back to join the guys, see if everything's okay.
The thing is, my father was a naval man, you know. And he used to play a game with me called, I don't know if you've heard the game, called Russian Roulette. You've never played Russian Roulette before?
Oh my God, Mr. John, please, no.
Well, this guy really can't handle his drink.
I hear footsteps.
Hey guys.
You, sir, sit in the corner. Go now.
Sorry?
What am I going to do with you? What am I going to do with you, sir? Go in the corner. Go in and put your hands on your head.
Me? Are you talking to me?
Yes, I'm talking to you, sir.
Ian, Mr. William, he got me tied up.
What's going on?
I don't know. I think maybe it's a drink going on.
I'll just leave. I'll leave you alone.
My father always told me, shut up, boy. You're a boy. You nothing. You're a boy. I'm a mature person. You are nothing but children. I love my children. Did I tell you I love my children? Have you found my children? I don't know. Have you seen my children? Have you seen my children?
No. Have you seen any? No, I haven't seen children.
No.
I didn't know you had children.
Hey.
Walter, say nothing. Have you seen any children?
No.
Yes or no?
No.
No. I did not think so. I love my children. I need my children. You, sir. You will stay exactly where you are. Or you will find yourself dead. Move your hands, Mr. William, and you will be shot.
Come on, Mr. John, don't do that.
Walter, I will rephrase the question, my good man. You ever played Russian roulette before? I played Russian roulette before. I played with my father. You remember, I was telling you about my father. He's a very strict man, a very straight man. Yes. Yes. No. People call him evil. No, I don't think he's evil. I think he was a fair man, a hard man. Yes, a fair man. So we're going to play a game called Russian Roulette.
Please, Mr. John, please.
Do you understand the rules, sir? Do you understand the rules?
What would Dick say if he was here now?
Oh, Dick. Dick Rotman.
Would you just say... Would you...
He...
Hey, did you say Dick? Did you say Dick?
He was a scholar. He was a scholar, sir.
I've heard that name, Dick Rampin. I've heard of him.
I told you, sir. One word out of you, and you were.
I haven't moved my hands. I've done. You didn't mention. Your body. You didn't mention talking. You said keep my hands on my head, and they are here.
Do not. Both of you do not mention his name in my presence. He was a scholar. He was a lovely man. And I will not have his name taken in vain.
You knew him? You knew Dick Rampin?
I knew him well. He was a scholar.
I did too.
He was a gentleman, sir. He was a gentleman. He was a fine artist. Of many a tune. He passed himself off as some sort of belittled musician, but I saw a magnitude that in him that you still would never understand.
Is that what you're saying? You saw a magnitude of Dick?
Yes. Yes. It grew every day.
That's what I heard. That's the rumours obviously are true then if you knew him.
Yes. Yes. And it was always, always wrong men. But that's another story. But I tell you, sirs, do not mention Dick's name in my presence. Sorry, gentlemen, I seem to be a little bit hesitant in there. What am I doing? Yes. I was going to kill you, yes. I was going to kill you. Oh, silly on me. I told you before, Walter, do not give me alcohol. Because I turned into my father. My father was an evil man. A fair, a just man. Yes. So we're gonna play this little game called Who's going to live and who's going to die? Yes.
Please,
I think that's rather spiffy.
Come on, Mr. John, don't do this. You're the only person that I know that I thought I could trust. Don't do this, Mr. John. Please.
What are you begging for your life for? Why are you begging? We have this Mr. William here. That's out the first bullet. Yes.
Hey, now.
I've got 2-for-1. Yes, 2-for-1. Would you like to live? Or would you like to die, sir? The choice is yours.
Who made you the person that chooses?
Because I am, at the moment, I am God. I can choose whatever I want.
God doesn't exist.
That's the power. Oh yes, God does exist. Meet your maker, sir. Oh, bravo. Oh, bravo. Walter, what are you doing? It's your turn, sir, now. It's your turn.
This guy's totally lost it. I've got to do something. I've got to get out of here before we both get bloody shot. Don't do it, John. Don't do it.
Are you ready to meet your maker, Walter? Are you ready to meet your maker? Do you want to play a game? Yes.
The Lord is my shepherd. I will fear no man. For thou art.
Don't do it, John.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death.
This is rather a good game, isn't it? Now it's my turn.
This could be my chance. I'm going to try and sneak out the door while he's occupied and shooting himself in the head. The mad bloody fool. Well, that worked well, didn't it?
No offence there, Mr. William, but one has to take the precautions, you see. Because if we're going to play the game, we have to play the game properly. It's not going to put my gun against my head, and then you two fine gentlemen decide to put a bullet in me, you see. So, let's play the game.
I could never kill you, Mr. John. You ain't yourself.
Let's play the game.
Don't do this, Mr. John. Stop! Stop! No! Mr. John! No!
Oh, I do believe I got away with that one. Oh, Mr. William, do you know where to continue with our game? Oh, are you the same? I've still got the gun against
John,
my
you let him go while you still can.
Come on.
Or I'll shoot you down.
William.
Let him go, yeah. John.
Come on.
Hey, stop it now. No.
You want to see me kill myself?
Stop it. No, stop it, Mr. John. Stop it.
Here you go. See you. Come on, William. Come back in, William. Come on.
Stop it. Mr. William, stop it.
Put the gun down, John, or I'm going to take your head off.
Put the gun away, Mr. John. Put the gun away, Mr. John. Put it away now. Play the game.
What have we got? What can we do? You're weak. You're worthless. Go.
You need to go to bed, Mr. John. You need to go to bed.
What's that?
You need to go lay down somewhere.
You're weak, sir.
Stop this now. This ain't you talking now. Stop this.
You're weak and worthless. You're weak and worthless. Like my father said before, you are weak. Grow a backbone, you worthless piece of shit. I never want to see you again. Get out of my sight.
You don't mean that, Mr. John.
I should either leave and save myself, or shoot this bastard down. But Walter's loyalty, well, I've never seen anything like it. The guy's just had a gun put to his head and still, he's trying to save John.
Walter, go. I will put a bullet in you. I love you.
Hey, where I come from, family don't give up. If you're going to be the one to kill me, you might as well get it over with, because you're family now.
I told you before, Walter, I am two people. I fight the drug. You force alcohol in me and I got the taste. Now, walk Walter before I am too late. No.
No.
Please, before I kill you. I will kill you.
What am I supposed to do? What?
I will find you, Walter. Kill me. I will find you.
Walter, come with me. Come with me. Let him sleep it off. Walter, come with me. Come with me, Walter. Come on, quickly, run.
Don't aim a gun at him now. Come on now.
I'm just watching
Don't do
him
that.
Go. I'm just watching him go. Get out of here quick. Come on, let's go. What the fuck was that about?
I don't know, Mr. William.
That man's insane.
He not insane. He not. And the first time he ever said something mean on purpose.
Jesus. Now you see why I stick to myself most of the time.
Yeah, me and him been running together for months now.
Keep your eyes open, he could come around again. Follow me, mate, follow me. Let's put some distance between us and him. You say he's never done that before?
No, sir.
If it wasn't for you, I'd have put a bullet in him as soon as I got outside that house.
Well, thank you, because that was not Mr. John. I don't know what happened, but that was not Mr. John.
And keep your wits about you. If he comes back in that psychotic state, I can't promise I won't shoot him.
Please no, Mr. Wayne. Please no.
Well, if it's him or me, I'm gonna choose me every time.